morning, everyone. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Yes, we have with here Sir Yogesh Rotliwala, and he is the principal at Pacific School of Engineering, Surat. Sir will be answering some of our questions, and we will be giving his insight to us. Welcome, sir. So, I will start with the first question, sir. So, what are the key factors that keep you connected with the education sector?
Okay. Mr. Sakal, very good morning. Let me first congratulate to the team of College Dunia, and very much thankful for giving me an opportunity to share my thoughts in the area of the education field.
Yes, sir.
As I can say something about myself, I'm chemical engineer. Since last 25 years, I'm been acting as an academician. I'm a fortunate part to be the part of active member in the field of research and consultancy for various industries of the Gujarat state. I have successfully completed 5 research projects offered by central and state government. I'm also holding a patent and credited to more than 10 international publications. Presently, I'm acting as a supervisor, PhD supervisor for 4 candidates. And I believe that this kind of my professional and skillful journey should be transferred to our young technocrats, young engineers. That's why I would like to prefer to be attached in education field.
Surely the students are gaining a lot from you, sir. So, sir, being the principal, what is your philosophy of leadership? How would you describe your leadership style?
Truly speaking, the engineers are known for their expertise in science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, that is STEM. By applying their STEM knowledge to solve complex problems, engineers find innovative answers to some of the world's most puzzling questions. While their technical expertise is extraordinary, some engineers may lack the necessary leadership that needs training to excel in industry. It's need of the day. Personality grooming must be the part of at the level of the school as well as the level of the colleges. It is the need of the day. What I mean to say that leadership quality is missing in engineering knowledge. It must be given a remarkable weightage among all the technical subjects, and it's a need to develop technical leadership quality. My leadership quality, if I talk about my leadership quality, that mainly includes with lead others, influence others, and be a role model. I think this kind of the strategy will give a more systematic discipline culture at a glance in organized.
Yes, sir. So, in your experience, what can an inbound student gain from studying here in your institute?
As far as higher education concerned, there is a need of skill. Skill is very much important. Of course, we are here to give the knowledge, but skill is missing. We are much more focusing on skill-based technical knowledge. Frequent visits at industry is very much essential. The getting consultancy projects at institution level, the involvement of consultancy projects for the students are very much essential. That part is missing. To provide the industry institute interaction, if the institute can build up such kind of a culture in institute at the level of institute, it is the way by which we can have more exposure to the industries. Like if I talk about our organization, we have established a numerous way by which we can interact with the industry people. We have two research laboratories that name as environmental audit cell and civil material testing. Both the laboratories are NABL accredited, National Board of Accreditation for the laboratories. Apart from this, the Gujarat Pollution Control Board, that is GPCB, Gandhinagar, and Road and Building Department of the Gujarat State, Ahmedabad. They have approved our college to take up a consultancy project. And these two research labs are working in such a way that straightway we are involving our students in a projects, in a consultancy projects. Like if I talk about the environmental audit cell, that is related to the pollution control, that is related to the chemical products formulation. A straightway we are involving students. They are always with us during the project period. They are referring the actual scenario at industry. We are trying to find the problems of the industry. And we are working with the industry. In last 5 years, we have realized with this mechanism, we can improve the placement scenario of our organization. The straightway, after completion of the projects, the straightway students are getting benefits in the form of their placement at that particular industries. With this, there is an opportunity for the faculty members to upgrade their knowledge, to update their knowledge. They can see the requirement of the industries and they are making, they are involving that kind of the industry knowledge, industry exposure directly to the students. This is the kind of the culture. I think if we refer this kind of the culture in a prison setups, definitely this kind of things will provide a skillful and knowledgeable exposure to all students.
Sir, definitely. So, as you have, sir, described that your institution is highly involved with the industry. So, sir, how does the academics or the curricular of your institution ensure that the interaction is very good?
Okay. Our college is approved by AICTE New Delhi and affiliated to Gujarat Technological University. Very frequently, the authorities are providing an opportunity to share our view. We are frequently inviting industry people for expert talk as well as to refer their needs. And finally, we are trying to convey their responses to the universities. Universities have their own board of studies to revise the syllabus. And I'm pleased to inform you that now onwards, university is going to give an opportunity of 1 year period. During that 1 year of period, students will get the benefit of the internship at industry. Of course, nowadays, they have a 1 year period of the project. But industry is now trying to revise that 1 year project into the internship project. So most of the students will complete their curriculum within a 7th sem in a period of 3.5 years. And they will work as a professional engineer in a final year. Once they complete their 6 months successfully, if industry will happy with their work, they will have a certification, and based on that certification, students will have a final certificate of their graduation. I think this kind of the mechanism will definitely work for better placement and for the production of skillful engineers.
Yes, sir. So I would like to ask you, sir, when you first came to Pacific School of Engineering, so, sir, what was your vision for the school, and how has it changed over the years that you have been there?
Okay. Some of the key areas required to refer as academics administrator. Some of the challenges, you can say it's a kind of the challenges for each and every colleges. The discipline culture, the need of the day, the shortage of the resources, technical vacancies, teachers' vacancies, accountability and performance of the teachers, lack of employable skills, and accreditation of the institution. These are the challenges. These are the challenges. It's not so easy to overcome. But as an academician, as an administrator, we should refer this all the challenges in a stepwise manner. It's not so easy to get skillful teachers, knowledgeable teachers. The teacher must have ability to convince the students. Research and teaching, learning process are having a very, having a very thin difference. Mm-hmm. It's my belief. Sometimes it may happen to the professor who can do the research, they have some problems to convince the students in terms of teaching learning process. So, it should be classified. Both the kind of the characteristics are the need of the any technical institution. Research is very much essential. Of course, teaching learning process is also the part of the core requirement. So, we should be classified the category of the professor. So, these are the challenges. One more thing is that the shortage of resources. Of course, many times it is observed that as per the AICT norms, institute may be fulfilling the requirement, but for updation of the resources is lagging behind. Like if you can talk software development, Aspen, HiSys, AutoCAD, some of the institutions are not taking care to get this kind of the resources. The association with the IITs, that is also missing sometimes. So, with the passage of the time, institute has to update this kind of the resources, and this resources will definitely useful to upcoming technocrats.
Sir, so sir, lastly, I would like to ask you that what do you see your institution? Where do you see your institution in the next 10 years? What will be the top priority for your institution in the next 10 years?
Our dream is that our engineers, our technocrats will be known for their work in industries in next 10 years. Our college will be the brand, and all the students live their good life with technical knowledge, and the leadership will be useful for the society. This is our dream.
Okay, sir, thank you very much for the interview. It was very insightful. I'll be ending the interview now. Sir, I'm very thankful to you for being a part of this. Thank you, sir.